peoples, how you doing, Honeyboo Pie Pies? I just got out of a meeting with the team, and we're looking at the feedback from yesterday's show. And boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I just want to take time out and appreciate my YouTube family, the haters, the lovers. Y'all is something. But most importantly, it helps us see our chain of thought. You know, as the youth in this country, and even out there in the diaspora, it helps us gauge what we're dealing with. What's our generation going to be like in the next, 10 decades, 1 decade, 2 days? Who knows? The interfacing online, it helps me a lot. Anywho, gratitude aside, my name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. You know how you guys always tell me, touchy, not the anointed of the Lord, and I always tell you I am not touching the anointed of the Lord per se. I am just voicing out opinion. Our God is not a damn God. Our God is like a parent. He wants you to say, no, I will not go with that, but then ask, why won't you go with that? He wants a back and forth. He wants you to understand where he's coming from. So I'm not just touching the anointed of the Lord. I am seeking. Yes, I am seeking. I'm a faithful. That aside, so Pastor Bujingo and his wife of 29 years, yes, of blissful marriage, are breaking up. Now, the story started in movie Ampola. Before we know it, it escalated. She came out. She actually did sit down with the New Vision and gave us an exclusive into pretty much everything. As for Bujingo, we got a tiny part of his. Now, according to them, this whole wrangle has started not because of the marriage being horrible or whatever. They are saying it's because, according to Pastor Bujingo, Nemuwala Wabo Mukulu, who is 27 years old, want to steal church land. Bujingo is saying, nah. The woman, on the other hand, is saying, well, look here, this man, all of a sudden, we've been living a blissful life for 29 years of marriage, and then until 3 years ago, he switched it up. His lanes changed. He started coming late home, and then before we knew it, he started coming back home once in a while, and then before we know it, he was not coming home at all. When I confronted this man, he told me that he will go and tell the congregants, Andiga, that I'm trying to steal the land for myself, because according to her, that's the best blackmail that he could come up with. I'm like, okay, it's getting interesting. Let's do this. Let's listen. Now, she says, rumor has it, she found out that he was actually living with another woman. He was building her another house, and it seems he has found someone else. That's why he has been pressing her for a divorce. She says, no. Pastor Bujingo always fights for the Bible. Remember when he made those remarks of Holy Ghost fire and Holy Ghost, those ones, and he banned Bibles. She says, he fights for the Bible. Let him show me in the Bible where a divorce is allowed. I am not moving an inch. He, on the other hand, is still saying the only issue I have with that woman and her child, or our child, is they want to steal church land. I'm like, wait, this is getting interesting. Now, I don't know if all of you have put your ear to the ground, but those who used to actually pray at Pastor Bujingo was a while back will remember there is a time when they did a drive, and the whole drive was towards buying land for the church. Now that drive, yagamba buli muntu mundigale to send him a dollar. Bali ba ina dollar account. It doesn't matter if you were bringing $50, if you were bringing pennies, whatever. If it was not regular currency, they got you. Mali muziteka yonga. You were happy. You were going to buy land. Now he says, when they bought the land the first time, due to pressure, he did what all the other pastors do. He put the land in his and his wife and child and children's names. But then he said it was unfair because the land does not belong to them. It belongs to the church. So he switched it up. He changed. Listen to me slowly. He says he didn't want to be like all the other pastors. So he switched it up and put his wife, child, him, and added other three people on that same title. Now we're looking at the three people that he added according to his wife. He says, omu amugulide motoka, omu ali muzimbire nyumba, omu bagenda muzimbire nyumba bamugulire ne motoka. Na gamba yi, ate what about the senior heads in church? Why these three people? Why are they the ones on the land title? I'm like, first of all, hello! Endigaza mukama muzukuke.
wagenda n'obonaabonera akasente ko ekikumi ebibiri olwataano n'olutwalayo n'ogamba mu linnya erya Yesu Mukama kankusige mu chachi. Let me build you a temple for you will build a temple in my heart. Right? N'ozitwala ewa bugingo laba ebivuddeyo. Omukazi omwana abachachi be balirwanira ettaka. Ettaka lye mwewaayo ne mugamba katuligule lyaffe we tugenda osabira. Yo pastors, hmm? Hey! I honestly love this. Because I've been waiting. Bajampola. Gwedinda call wambonye. Runa tedo tuka. Bajampola. You will realize these things. Now, most of you are going to be like, no, you know, this would happen to anyone. The church always fights when it comes to things like that. Blah, blah, blah. It could happen to any other church. Yes, it could. But I thought, key in point, wemwali mungitandike chintu chino, etakaliali dina kubera lia church. It's siria individual. Kuba among you individuals who are fighting for this land, not a single soul put a penny to it. Y'all put prayers on it, which I guess are more they're more important than the pennies, but hello, child. And what's with all this washing out your linen in the public? 29 years you've been married to someone, and then you remember after 29 years how she's a lazy wife. She's a pastor at your church. You stand up, kukatuti, ate ya muvumane mu church. It goes without saying. You see, I always say, you will tell someone from the fruits they bear. Pastor Bujingo is known for being like a mini scoop on scoop, but the church version. Ayi mirira kukatuti navu mabulichiramu, bulichifu, bulichikunta, buliechitambula. Right? That's your pastor right there. So he stood up in church with a congregation that follows him. Endigaze, he has probably celebrated way too many marriages. He has been a part of way too many marriages. So he stood up in church. Navuma omukazi womukulu namugamba nabagamba ngabali okubeta kale. Once you take the land, blah blah blah, you're done with her. You said all types of things. Kukatuti mwendigane msigalanga muchaina hope, faith, true and true believing. What is wrong with Africa? What is so bad? Why can't we use logic? What is so hard about honestly sitting down and thinking some of these things through Mwenge and Diga? Meanwhile, I was looking at the pastor's home. Oh, Farouk, did you see the pastor's home? Na yankula girambu na ringe nzeke wabu jingo kukekana. Nga abantu bali okusumba. Ate ya baguba uku church. His church is not like every other church. Mboinzo kujano, ufuna wewe baka, nobera, wonga mkama buomulinda kukolele, no. Boba bagoba, no bagoba, mfulmesa wazo kusabazawe de, they lock the place up. Omusumba wamu, aine nyumba eva wano, mpaka hiri eri, siya sente entono, na ya kumwe ba sumba, ata simwe baba, simwe abatini, mwe ba anji, temulina na chakulia, temulina na jemusula. I'm not going to attach this to faith now. I'm going to attach this to logic, to knowledge. And what's sad is how you blindly believe. Nzabana itosokula kungamba mbo baibe gamba, do as I say and not as I do. Na ene nzija mchachi yongo omulimo gwo kuvuma abantu kukatuti chilo na misana. All in the name of preaching. And now you drag your wife. Where is the respect in that? Where is the respect in your marriage? You have 4 kids with this woman. Where is the respect? Ne mama batogerako ho muberanga nsana fuziba iye mubuto wewe temogera ku mantu ba faith. You don't know the understanding of faith. Just because we sit out here and you think we're in a secular world, I would challenge any one of you who wants to hit me back in the comment section. You want to go one on one with me spiritually in faith, hit me up. Let's have this conversation, because jenga batutulano ne tubagamba mugule wa maso mloza fe tuli bansi. No, my dear, you cannot be of this world if you're not of the flesh. And you cannot be of this world if you're not of the flesh and of the spirit, because your flesh carries the soul. Just like you cannot be of the soul and the flesh and not be of this world. But hey. Yeah, baby, food dekana. Meanwhile, I saw soda siwabwe. He's even into making sodas. Fresh Kid is the first of Kanan soda. It's a tight thing. We got up to a hawk story, I think yesterday by one. It started actually on the weekend. So we got up to a hawk story that Ankansime and her guy had drowned in a Canadian or American lake or something. I was like, the very first time when it hit me, I was like, this is some dumb-ish. That's why I didn't even bother talking about it yesterday. Anyway, Unconsume comes back out after it had gone massively viral and everyone was asking if she's okay, what happened, is she good? And she took to social and she's like, I'm tired. I'm going to begin shaming people. When we are living our good lives, when we're celebrating all these good things, y'all never holler to just check up on us and ask, are you good? Are you fine? And then she linked this to, that's why we had depression and blah, blah, blah. It was comical, if you ask me. She really spoke her mind. But if you ask me, I don't think it was necessary for her to do that. But then again, she's Unconsume. I thought she would have let it play out in a way that should have come out and said, no, it's a hoax story, we're good, we're fine, and keep it moving professional like that. I didn't think she needed to have the ratchet edginess to it, but hey, she's an entertainer. Anything for us to get them likes and them follows, we shall effing do, with the exception of me. I'm just saying, so I'm calling it. But anyway, yeah, in case you're still wondering, they're alive, they're fine and happy. That's the most I could go with it. Mm-hmm. Woo! Before I can say bye-bye, word coming in from Lagos, Nigeria, and Tanzania, and South Africa. Child! So, Peace Square, Peter Okoye and Zari have taken up a thing of clowning Diamond Platnumz with their different responses to each other's social media or new music or anything like that. And then Diamond Platnumz, being the idiot and dimwit that he is, who doesn't understand that they put him down, hands down, is also still pushing Tanasha. Now, yesterday I watched Tanasha Shimbu. She's so talented, according to her boyfriend. That is not a song, Tanasha. That was you. Okay, it was probably a new Tanzanian style where you're mumbling through a song and just trying to look good. Girl, it's a bad look. You should stick to being a TV host. As for Zari and P Square, y'all do you. I can't even. Your levels of petty are too low. I mean, what amazes me about these people is that they actually don't understand. The internet never forgets. Yes. 50 years from now, when you're dead and all of that, we still keep all this ish. It's going to be fun in the next generation. Our kids are going to be looking at half the stories that were running then and go like, ish. Y'all had it bad. Anywho, that's been my time. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram at TinaFierce1 with an H. Hit me up in the comment section. That's, of course, on YouTube and on any of our different social media platforms. Tuayet, Kwataganet, Connecting Gay. You know what I'm saying? I'm out. Peace.